I got information about how the Department of Information has got challenges in terms of, you know, resources that we are addressing. We've raised a little money from UNDP, which I would like us to spend a bit on this project. I'm negotiating for some little funding from the Ford Foundation that I would like to spend on this department as we go forward. And we are trying to see whether we can put in some little money in the supplementary budget targeted at supporting this department. Because I can assure you, and this is going to be my last point, we have a lot of potential here. Tuko pamoja. From 1st of July, all public servants will belong to the ministries where they are. You will all be my staff. No one will be for treasury, no one is going to be for government printer, no one is going to be for everywhere. If you are an accountant, you are a finance officer, you are going to be the finance officer of the Ministry of Information, Communication and Technology. You'll be promoted here or fired here. That is all. It's not going to be a case where if there's a problem, we have to now go to the government printer and tell them what to do with you. We are the ones who will know what to do with you. So every staffer in the ministry is going to belong to the ministry where they are from 1st of July. That will then harmonize, the scheme. Or the scheme of service, as it were, so that mobility is determined in a particular way. You will not be transferred. When you have messed things or have come to work and found you left your jacket there and lied that you have gone to the cyber cafe, so that tomorrow we actually go and transfer you to the Ministry of Water. Say you are a problematic person. There are public servants who have made their career in the public service has been just loitering around ministries. You mess in information, you are taken to agriculture. You stay 2 weeks or 3 months or a year, you mess there, you are moved to water. From water, you mess there, you go to environment. You mess there, you go to health. So that the entirety of your life, you have just been wasting time in the public service. The point is this, I'm not saying that anyone is going to be laid off and we are not going to act on a whim. What we are going to do is, that is a rationalization process. Every one of us will look at, you have the staff you need. Those that you feel you do not need in your ministry, you surrender them to the pool. So that then they can go to Kajiado County and probably do a better job for the county government, or they can go to Marsabit and do a better job there for the county government of Marsabit. We want to use the resources that we have as public service effectively. This business of lumping people in one ministry, you have 7 accountants, and when you look at the actual work you do, it can be done by 1 accountant, or 2 accountants for that matter. So why not surrender the other 5 accountants so that the Ministry of Livestock, which has got 1 instead of 7, can actually also have the accountants they need. So that's what the rationalization is going to be. And those who are here, we are going to be so inflexibly driven by performance and delivery, and we will come up with criteria. Those staffers who perform very well, they will be rewarded. You know, in many environments of the world, you can actually earn more money than your boss. Did you know that? You'll be promoted progressively. You'll get to a point where you can actually earn more money than your boss. Because if a cabinet secretary enters the public service at a particular job group, and you have been there as the chief photographer in the Ministry of Information, and you have been earning increments, you have been registering outstanding performance and getting increments over a period of time, chances are that you will actually get to a point where you almost earn the same amount of money as your cabinet secretary earns, even if you are the chief photographer. In other words, we want to run the public service the way the private sector is run. And you have seen what has been released by the Ministry of Devolution and Planning, my colleague Anne Waigoro, that in certain job group cadres, the jobs will be committed to contract, a fixed term contract. You work for 3 years and your contract is renewed based on, obviously, on your performance. You can do wonders. You are capable of doing wonders. You will shock people until people come to this department from the public service. They want to know what is going on in that department. There are people there we must see. You are capable of doing that if you decided. It's going to be a system of reward. In other words, the people who do well are rewarded and they are given even a bonus. At certain job groups, your job will be committed to contract.